Hi, and welcome to OS Tips from OS Training. I'm Rod Martin. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to build a Joomla distribution so that you can create brand new websites out on the internet anytime you need that are practically ready to go. So what's a distribution? Well, a distribution in Joomla is nothing more than creating a site, adding all of your favorite extensions to it, entering your licensing code, and then using a Kiba backup to create the site out on the internet. It's not hard to do, but it will save you so much time. Let's go. So I have my base Joomla site here ready to go. Of course, it needs some updating, and so here's the process that I go through. I maintain a Joomla site like this with all of the extensions that I usually use, and I maintain it locally on my own machine using MAMP. Now, if you need instructions on how to install MAMP or WAMP or something like that, head over to ostraining.com. Once I've got MAMP set up and I've got a base Joomla site set up, then every once in a while when I need to create a new one, I come into it and run all of the updates. And that's really simple to do. I'm just going to do that right now. And obviously I shortened that for the length of the video. So my Joomla installation is up to date, and here are some of the extensions that I tend to use. Now, again, I'm not promoting any extensions here at all. These are the ones that I use on most of my websites, and I think that's the key. You want to get the ones that you use generally on every website, not everything under the sun. And so these are the ones I use pretty much on every website that I build. You'll note Admin Tools is installed, but I haven't done the Quick Setup Wizard because that's best done on the site once it launches. So now that Joomla's up to date, I'm going to update all of my extensions. So everything is up to date when I take my first backup. One of the advantages here is I've put all of the licensing codes in for all of the extensions that I've paid for, so I don't have to do that when I put the site up to an actual server. The only exception to that might be something like RS Forms Pro, which requires a license per site in order to be updated. And as usual, there might be a few extensions that you can't automatically update, depending on whether your licensing is up to date or whether you've got the license code put in. So again, I'd encourage you to get all of these up to date before you take your backup. Now, using a Kiba backup, and the free version is just fine for this process, I can take a quick backup. Of course, I shortened that process for the length of the video. Now I click Manage Backups, and here's the backup that I can grab. And since it's local, I don't actually need to download that. But there it is, it's now in my Downloads folder. All right, the next step then is to quickly head over to where you're building your new site. And I already have a section ready to go on a live server. I'm going to click File Manager, and I'm putting this in a subdomain of a domain that I'm going to upload that JPA file. And I need kickstart.php. You can get that from akibabackup.com as well. That's the file that runs the process of unpacking and installing your new site. And upload that at the same time. All right, so I've got my JPA file and my kickstart.php file. I can close that window, and I can head back over to my control panel in cPanel and create a new database. This is the only other step that's required before we actually get our site up and running. So I'm going to run through the database wizard. So the next step is just to open that URL. You should see your JPA and kickstart.php. Click on kickstart.php, press escape. I'm going to go through this really quickly because I typically just use the defaults. Click Start. It's going to unpack my JPA file or the backup file that I created. Run the installer. It's going to run a check of all of the PHP on my site. You should see all green here. If you don't, you'll need to contact your host to fix that. Click Next. You'll enter the database information that you set up in the previous step. Click Next. And it's going to restore your database. My database is restored. Click Next Step. I don't have to fill any of this in. I can update that here, or I can just do that under Global Configuration once the site launches. If you want to update any of the super user settings, you can do that here. And typically the defaults here are fine. Click Next. It's done. Clean up. And go to my site's backend, where I can now log in. And my website is up and running on my new domain, with all of the extensions I would normally have that would take a lot of time to install and configure. All right, so that's a Joomla distribution. Using Akiba Backup, it is going to save you incredible amount of time as you create new Joomla websites out on the internet. Well, this is OS Tips from OS Training. Thanks for watching today. I've put a link to the entire Akiba Backup class at ostraining.com in the session notes below. Please subscribe. I'm Rod.